this is 2 weeks of my scrap paper collected in my apartment together from flyers or paper packaging material or mails and eggshell egg holder case. And so 2 weeks of that, it came up to this big bag, and it is 600 gram. So what I want to look at it, is this scrap paper where it came together in 2 weeks, is it garbage or recycled? Because if it is recycled, I mean, here in Ontario, we are only recycling one stream. So paper and plastic, it goes into one recycle bin. And then I looked at this recycling bin, how it looks like paper and plastic thrown together. Like, who are these people on the other end who can pick this paper and plastic separate? Because if you throw these little pieces, like if I throw this bag into the big, huge container or recycle bin, this is going to stuck to the plastic because it's going to be wet. And is somebody going to be able to hand pick this apart? So I don't think so. And I was always wondering about that. I'm like, am I throwing this paper, this scrap paper into the recycling bin, or is this garbage? So I think this paper is not garbage whatsoever. Like, you can make handmade paper out of it, or you can make lots of things out of it. So I think that it should be a two-way stream of recycling. So have to be separated by paper and plastic ahead of time. Like, in the building downstairs, we should have another bin just for paper. And then I think if we would do that, we could save a lot of money or space on the landfill. Because that's the problem, right? That the landfill is filling up. So if we could separate the paper ahead of time at home or in downstairs in the garbage recycling room, we could save a lot of paper. So anyway, this is what I'm trying to prove. And I'm going to make recycled paper out of it. So this is how you make recycling paper. Basically, take them into little pieces, one by one. Like this size. This is how much I did already. Like that. Step on. Okay, so I cut it up this much. And now we soak it for a night here. Soak it for the night. So when it goes to the Hollander beater, it is going to be faster. So this is the paper for next to the next day today. And then it's gonna go into the beater. Okay, so this is the Hollander beater and all this paper gonna go in here. But before, I have to put 2/3 of water into the beater, okay. Maybe I do this with the bucket faster. Okay, so I put the paper into the Hollander beater. Ready to go. So this is how the beater look like, and then these things here is gonna go 30 minutes. So since that's running, I need my station ready. This is where I'm going to put the paper, and then this is where I make the paper with this tool. And then further, I draw all these things where I'm going to put into the paper, and then I'm going to make forms also. Yeah, almost going to be ready. So it's almost ready, and then so I'm going to see if the papers are so you're supposed to be able to tell from this if the paper fiber is ready or not. I think it's ready. So yeah. So the fiber is ready. I turned it on. It's pretty disgusting. And I have to unplug this in the middle there, and then that's gonna go into here, and I have to do the whole thing. This is going to be crazy to clean it out. This is very disgusting. Okay, so like that, the whole Hollander bitter. So now cleaning it. This all have to be cleaned. And then it's dripping there. And then from there, you put it into here. This is very messy. And then I have, we'll see how much I have. Okay, so this much happened, half of the bucket. And then it's pretty disgusting, like that. And then put some in. So some of the paper, this one, this is wallpaper. It wasn't enough the half an hour for them, or maybe it need longer time. This is different kind of paper. It didn't came off. Anyway, this is good. And this is the tool I'm going to make the paper with. So this is how the paper making is happening, but I cannot record it better because I have to use both of my hands. So paper. So I finished with my papers and all these papers I made like that. Each layer has one paper. And then I made all those paper. Each layer is a paper. And then I made these ones too. These are supposed to be biodegradable flower pot. Well, not just flower pot like this. I want to make a globe, and it would be the flower pot, and maybe I paint it. And then I just made smaller biodegradable, but it was very hard actually to make it. The paper was melting apart, and hopefully this will stay like this. Nobody going to touch it because it's gonna fall. I put it on the balloon. Next step. Okay, so this is the next step. I have four board paper, what is this called, wool, and different kind of layers, and I put sandwich the papers in here to press the butter out of it. One more.
so this is how it works. Very complicated machine. Now we wait for a little bit until the water is coming out, and then ready for the drying part.
This person, like, is now expecting, like, you know, like, I would probably say, like, I'll do it this last minute, and then I would.
So this is how the next step goes, like this. Oh, I cannot. Huh. Smaller. This is the rack, and then I have the paper, like here, and then you just... So I have one more. Yes.
Are you a student?
No.
So unfortunately, this is the research machine that needs to be used.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Okay, so one by one, like that. So I made 63 paper. One second. Two. And three. 63 paper. 600 gram. So I finished the paper making, recycled paper making. I am deadly tired, sweating. I made 600 gram of scrap paper, and it turned out 62 piece of paper, but that was like laminated because I put like double, so double two paper is one paper. So basically I made 120 paper, and then so I'm tired, and it was 6.5 hours. Yeah.
So I have the papers that I made from scrap paper, and I turn it into recycled handmade paper, and this is how they look like. The first batch, I made this twice. The first batch was 400 gram of paper, this many, and the second was 600 gram, and it was long time and a lot of work, so I could not do this at home. It was, the facility was necessary for this to do, I thought first that I'm going to make it at home from a blender. Like, it's crazy how much work it was. Like, soon as when I saw like how much paper it came together and then how slow I make the paper, I'm like, oh yeah, I'm going to stand there all day long. It was fun. It was, these, I made some, maybe, recycled Christmas card. I gave it to my mom, like that. And I also made money, Canadian money. Because, so I thought if we could go two-way stream recycling, that's how we could save this money. If we pay, I mean, this paper, if we throw this paper to the recycling bin, nobody ever going to be able to pick it apart. Since then, I collected this much paper all over again. This is scrap paper. And then now, should I throw this to the recycling bin? Whoever is going to be able to pick this apart? I don't think anybody. So I don't think this video is finished because I still have this many paper and the school is closed for the summer, so I cannot use the whole under beater. So the home, like, this is already collected, and then I have to come to another solution how to repurpose this paper. And, yeah.